Kuya Dev, and currently at Prospol, and also founder and community manager of Tech Leadership for Philippines.
Okay, so yeah, I will be talking about, you know, protecting your applications against vendors, which could get me into trouble with PayMongo because they are a vendor.
Stop the talk. And
but no, of course, even PayMongo is using vendors themselves, I'm sure. So this will probably be applicable to their use case then. So without further ado, let's get started. So yeah, a little bit introduction about myself. So I'm Ben Lampa, also known as Kuya Dev. So I'm currently running a podcast. So okay, so another bag, just go ahead and subscribe. Also a self-taught web developer. I formerly actually front-end engineer, but since I'm a career shifter, so I'm shifting careers again into backend. So I'm focusing on the backend side of things. And yeah, kaya sila na ngayon na may handle ng front-end. Problema na nila ngayon yan. So, also, I'm also a speaker and community leader because nga, nag-start na rin ako ng back-end career ko. So, nag-start na rin ako ng back-end community. No? So, if guys here are interested in back-end JavaScript, sali kayo server-side JavaScript Philippines. So, it's a new community that I'm trying to build. Yeah, let's get started sa talk before. So a little disclaimer, no? Baka kasi there are people here who think more kaya nagkasalita kami dito, perfect yung code namin. Hindi ah. So don't do this introduction. So the purpose of this talk is to actually make you aware of these philosophies. Yung paano yung flow of thinking when using libraries or vendors. No, yung mga APIs na yan, namibayad. So, ano lang, for us to be careful, no, when we're building our projects. Kasi we might get into some traps. So, first, ano muna yung vendor lock-in? So, imagine this. Nari, nakapagtrabaho na kayo. You are using, I don't know, a login, third-party login service provider. So, maraming libraries yan, di ba? May API sila, may libraries sila na pwedeng install, pwedeng lagay sa application nyo. But, some often, you know, we forget na, okay lang, sige, lagay natin dito sa components natin. Madami natin components, ano lang, 1,000 components natin. Each component na may kailangan, sabihin natin 300 components. All use the API of that particular vendor. Paano yung vendor na yun magtaas ng price, tapos di na kaya ng budget niyo. But now, dahil nga in-embed nyo yung API nila sa sabi natin 300 components niyo, so it makes it hard for you now to actually switch from that vendor to another vendor na mas affordable. So that is a business risk na kailangan nating aware tayo as developers. No? Di lang tayo code lang ng code, we also need to be aware of the business side. Things. Hindi ko pa rin explain. Yun na yun. So, for example, you know, illustrate ko lang dito using some simple geometric circles. We have here your React application. And for example, you have that third-party library. Di mo pa ini-install, tinitignan mo pala. And, you know, you start installing it. No? Lalagay nyo na yung mga API nila, sa mga components nyo, sa mga hooks nyo, wherever. Then eventually, start really creeping into your application. So yung surface area ng API nila, parang naging mold, nag-mold na dun sa application nyo. So, this is bad, like I said. Paano nyo may naya-angle yan? Parang, nag-iisa na sila. They're almost one and the same. So, I think, for me, gawa na lang kayo ng bagong application niyan. Ang hirap na ipa-untangle niyan. But, maybe, no? There's still a way to get out of that. No? But of course, this is better if you do it the beginning pa lang. Pero, just to give you some idea, maybe that there's a path towards something like this, na medyo onti lang yung API surface, ano nila, surface area, dun sa application niya. So, again, if you're familiar with, ano, computer science, and abstractions, this would be the solution, one of the solutions na pwede yung gawin to achieve this. Okay, let's see some code. Bear with me kasi I haven't done this in a long while. I haven't done a tech talk talaga. So let's see if things work. Okay, so for example, you have a third-party library that has this API, you know, or has this interface. May method siya, upload file. Simple lang. It accepts a file, accepts a label for that file, returns the URL, sabihin natin. Then you use it, no? So you import the upload service, you use it, I don't know, maybe in your hook, wherever your application. Then, yun yung usage yun, upload service, yung import nyo, then dot upload file. So you provide the file, the label. In this case, you just console log the URL, whatever. Then, what if, you know, kailangan nyo ngayon magbago. Bago lumipat ng ibang service provider na may ibang API. So ito yung kanina, yung API nila. What if you need to use a competitor? Siyempre, iba yung API niya. Sabihin natin, execute upload naman yung pangalan ng function nila. Tapos, malala pa, yung parameter na ina-accept ng method, ano pa, object. File, title pa rin, no? Then, now, it also accepts or it returns an object na may success in URL property. So, medyo nagka-complex na. Mas mura siya, pero sabihin natin mas okay siya sa application nyo, but their API is much more complex. Baka naman kasi may mga features siya na in-action, na gusto nyong makuha, na wala dun sa previous nyo na vendor. So, you decide to do this. Pero yun nga, how do you move from that simple na API to this more complex API? So, is there a path towards that goal? So, ang useful na gagawin natin, di ba? Sabihin natin, ganyan lang, madali lang, di ba? Import lang, palit lang. Papalitan mo lang yung name ng method. And you provide the proper or yung API, sundan niya lang yung signature. So, imbis na two parameters, one parameter na lang na object na yan. No? Then, you do magdito deconstruction, no? So, you deconstruct the URL. And ganun pa rin, no? So, kumbaga, yung function mo, nagbago yung loob, pero yung signature niya talaga, di naman masyadong bago. But imagine doing this, no? For a lot of your components. Kung ginawa mo yan, in-install mo yung previous na library sa maraming components, sa 300 components, di uulitin mo to, no? Ayan. So, one way to do that is to abstract out yung function na ginamit natin. No? Yung mismo tayo. Ito, gagawin natin siya sa maraming components, we just abstract it out, pull it out, create an abstraction na would be consistent. No? Ang gagawin lang niya, magiging wrapper siya sa kung ano man yung library na i-install natin. No? So from here, nangyari, upload service pa rin. No? So ito yung luma na library natin, no? Tsaka yung implementation. Kunwari, di mo pa i-install. Ang ginawa mo muna, nag-refactor ka. In-extract mo yung function na yun. Ito one function na pwedeng i-install ng mga clients mo. So, kunwari, it's one of example of your client. Tapos, i-import na lang nila yung abstraction mo, yung parang wrapper function mo, no? So if you choose to actually stall na, no, yung competitor, madali na lang. Isang function na lang i-change mo, hindi yung marami, no? And in the future, kung magpapalit ka ulit, ganyan na lang ulit gagawin mo. You change just one location instead of multiple hundreds of locations. So, napakalaga ng abstraction. Okay, so I don't know what this is. Pagal ko lang ginawa ito eh. But, let's see. No? I'll try to recall lah. Okay. So, ito, gets ko na. So, let's see. Na front-end kayo. But you have a back-end. No? Or maybe you have other stakeholders na kailangan din mag-migrate. Kaya may database, may whatever. So, hindi lang front-end yung kailangan mag-migrate towards that new vendor. Yung iba rin. May back-end team kayo, malaki yung organization nyo. So, magiging problema na i-deploy nyo yun without naiintindihan dahil yung back-end nyo. So, mag-break yung application nyo. So, the usual na ginagawa, parang si front-end, parang irarap yan in what they call feature flag. No? So dito, ang implementation natin is siguro variable siya na pwede nyong ipalit-palitan. Pero there are other, again, vendors that do service for feature flagging. So, dito, ang gagawin lang natin, save. Yung kanina, ayan, di ba? Ito yung original na wrapper function natin. No? So, again, yung parang lumang service yan. But, you can now actually have them both together in that same function without changing your other components. So again, you're doing this in a single file. No? And, yun, they can coexist together. Kung mapapansin nyo, ito, hindi nagbabago to. Tsaka to, hindi nagbabago yan. So, yung mga, as far as your components and your application is concerned, consistent yung API nitong wrapper function. Nagbabago lang yung implementation. So, you can do whatever you wanna do here. Like, having two implementations, two libraries, at the same time. Depende na lang doon sa feature flag niya. No. Gets so far? Good. So, but how? Paano gagawin naman to for APIs na sobrang complex? Marami siyang methods, di ba? O marami, yung API niya sobrang laki. Tapos, your whole application is using almost all of them. So magiging problema yun yung ginawa natin yun. Okay yun, kung maliit lang yung API ng library. Pero pag malaki na siya, medyo problemado na tayo dito. So, hindi ko na siya i-discuss. No. Sorry. But, the idea remains the same. You have to find a way to abstract that. No. Maraming tayong pwedeng gamitin na strategies. And, buti na lang, no? Computer science gives us tools to do that. So, for example, sa design patterns, maybe adapter could work for your application, or maybe a bridge, or whatever. Ito, ginamit namin ito, yung plugin pattern, in which we wrap the vendor as a plugin, kumbaga. Tapos, pinaplug in namin siya sa application, depende dun sa feature flag. So, we were able to actually support kasi multiple websites kami. Some websites are using this vendor. That another website is using another vendor. So, it was possible for us. It was very tricky. It took us kasi nung in-implement yung library sa amin na yun, sobrang embedded na siya. Na, we didn't think of it. Apparently, the company was bought. So, nagbago yung naging motivation nila as a business. Naging profit-oriented sila. So, ginigipit nila kami. So, we had to find a way to untangle sila and move to another vendor. And also, to protect us from that happening again. So, yun yung ginawa namin, plugin pattern. You should research on this, parang kay, ano, kay, hindi ko na i-discuss. Lama natin yung oras. Another one, kung yung nabibigay ng component, yung API ng vendor, no? Kung nari, may component siya to fetch directly to their API, ayaw nyo nang gawin yun. Kung nari, upload niya, kung may mga ganun, di ba? Yung mga drop-down, upload na ano. So maybe you could wrap it using higher order components or maybe you could use post composition. No? Again, it will depend on your business. So, huwag niyong iisipin na walang way towards untangling yourself from a vendor. Kasi baka, lalo yung mga cloud services provider, baka may way tayo na hindi tayo vendor locked sa kanila. Docker is one answer, Kubernetes, ba? Baka kasi it can, other cloud providers have implementations of that, so nililipat mo lang. May mahirap pa rin, pero at least hindi ganun kahirap, hindi possible. Just to give you an idea, yung vendor namin yun, nung maglipat namin, took us 1 year to do that. So, our ownership had to do some business magic para syempre i-delay. So, it was a lot of pressure. Yung pressure yun, matindi yun. So, before you actually get to that point, make sure na protected kayo.
Name drop.
So, thank you. Yeah, follow me at kuyadev.com.
Akala ko may extract ko sa iyo yung ano eh. Sabihin mo na lang, Rem, kung ano yung service na pinaprovide.
Airport.